Hey, okay, and welcome to Drive Time, episode 26. This is a special 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time edition of the program. Coming to you live from my 2000 Honda Accord, which I just finished cleaning. So it smells like cleaning products in here, and the temperature has just plummeted. I'm wearing shorts. It's starting to get really cold. It's cooling off, like, big time. It's supposed to, I think, only be in the 50s tomorrow after it was in the mid-80s today. So that's whatever. But I'm going a different direction. This will be probably a little bit longer type of an episode because of that. Because I'm going to Old Navy. Getting myself some jeans. That's right, some Old Navy jeans. My wife gave me a coupon. And I said, well, typically I like to get, like, Levi's. So I get a pair of jeans, like, once every couple of years. The pair of jeans I had now haven't fit me for a long time. They're too big. They kind of look stupid. And they're stained. I had two pretty bad stains on them that, I didn't even try to see how I get out, but probably could get them out. But it was time. Of course, I took the hottest day of the year to go decide I need to get jeans. But anyway, that's where we're at. It's dusk. It's 7 p.m. on a Wednesday evening. And I'm driving Old Navy. If I have time, I might try and sneak by the record shop and sell. I have a bunch of used CDs in my trunk. And once I do that, my car will be purged of basically, it'll just be a car with nothing in it but a driver and an iPhone. But let me talk about the iPhone. If you're a long-time viewer of this program, you'll know on the last episode just cuts off, and that's why. Let me tell you why. I picked it up off the dashboard. This was at 12:30 p.m. today. I picked it up off the dashboard, and it was hot to the touch, super hot. And I looked on the screen and said, like, warning: overheating must can't function. Like I said, I wore on the screen of the iPhone was like, I'd never seen it before, and it was like super hot to the touch from being on my dash in the sun. So what does this mean? Well, it's cool now, and it's shady, and it's dusk, and there's a bunch of like ominous clouds rolling in, thundershower type clouds, so I'm not worried about that happening again now. But the future is uncertain in that for spring and summer, I'm not sure if it's the heat in the car and the heat in the car with that going on. That's probably not good for my phone to have it out in the direct sun under the windshield like that. So I don't know. I mean, I feel dumb right now. Unrelated, I feel dumb right now wearing shorts. That's for sure. I feel really dumb. So I'm cold driving right now. I was cleaning my car, and I was like, well, it was hot yesterday. Well, I started to clean my car, and I was finishing the job today, and I'm taking a couple days off from running, because I ran the half marathon, and then 7 miles, and so I was like 20 miles in 2 days, and my legs were really hurt, so I was like, I'm gonna take 2 days off. Whatever. I'm just trying to explain to you how a man gets to be 31 years old, living in New Jersey, driving to Old Navy alone on a Wednesday night and talking to himself, recording into his iPhone. A lot of choices had to be made to get to this point. Big time. Alright, so let me just hatch out some things that have been on my mind. I'm in a good rhythm in terms of doing what I call my three major serial projects. The three big ones are all, as of this moment, up to date, and I should have time to get them done so I don't get behind again for at least another week and a half this week. But some other projects that I want to do, like the podcast, I did 6 episodes, and I kind of left it open, like, well, I'm not going to do an episode every weekday or every Tuesday. I'm just going to do them when I do them, and I haven't done one in, like, a couple weeks. So I'm obviously not good at leaving it up to myself to try and fit all this together. I kind of need a schedule of things, I feel. So you know, and today at work was a shit, was a mess. I just, like, I found myself just not even doing anything. Just staring at Twitter, reading links, and, you know, that's not good. I can't, I gotta use that time. I'm up and I'm awake and I'm alert and I've got a real fast access going on with the computer. Because I'm not getting anything else out of that. What else? Getting right to the front of the lawn here. That's the nice. This is always a weird light coming up through right here, but it looks like I'm going to hit it almost perfectly. So, seatbelt time as we get on the highway. Music magazine, I'm in a nice group with that too. The music magazine, the actual zine part of it. Look, I created a zine for the month of January that came out in the early February. And my idea was to do one of these little magazine zine things once a month. And I haven't done one since. And I had the idea to, like, you know, and I don't care if I can get, if I get a February and a March version done now and I just post them and then that's what they are, that's fine, I don't care. No one, you know, it's very few hits on these things anyway. So, I was thinking of doing a cassette tape recording, and then maybe, like, the third issue would just be, like, a blog post on MySpace. I don't know. You know, like, something weird. Like, everyone will be in a different medium. Every single zine, monthly zine, will be a different format. I had an idea of doing a, but then the project just becomes sort of like, I'm doing it to, you know, I feel like I'm just going to scrap the zine altogether. And that one zine that I printed out and I had ordered from the MagCloud. Have you heard about this thing? The HP MagCloud? Yeah, pretty good. I had, let me put the window up. I really don't think you can probably hear me at all. And I'm cold anyway, so I don't even know, I had the window down. So this is a little different because I'm usually not on this type of road talking, so I'll try to be careful. I'm going to tell you the truth right now. I do like this idea of this cassette tape where I talk about the blues and it's kind of like really raw and stupid. And like, I was thinking about playing clips of like Nickelback and the Black Keys. I'm not sorry. But, you know, talking, like, trying to find some, like, earnest people making comments about the blues and to, like, form a compilation of, like, stealing interview stuff on YouTube as I, like, play, like, a fake bluesy riff on, like, the cheap Casio keyboard that I have. That was the idea for that. Then I had another idea of doing a book that I think can be its own book. And there's, and I'll talk about this right now. And I don't know why I would want to tie this into the music magazine because I feel like the idea is so different that if I did it, I should just release it as a book on my own. But anyway, there's a message board. It's the Ween, the band Ween, now broken up. They still have a fan message board that I've looked at and read for years without really ever posting. Posted like here and there. I mean, I'm talking over 10 years ago. I think I had a meltdown and I stopped, but I always read it, and it's weird. I've gotten to know some of these people who post on this thing. This sounds creepy and pathetic in a lot of ways, and I've realized that. But I find these people entertaining. We obviously have this starting comment of really being into the band Ween. There's one thread that's now up to 115 or so pages about one user who said it was set up by another user for this user to just talk about what he did that day. Basically, the guy is like 30-something years old, and he lives with his dad. His mom passed away. He's a junkie. He smokes crack. He does a ton of cocaine. And he just talks about what he does living at home and trying to... He's already had one job where he's washing dishes at a nursing home. And... Now he's working at a pizza place, and he's had a couple week or two now where he's been like relatively sober, and he's trying to get himself ready for summer. But he's basically, he talks about how he's destined to go on these benders again. And when he goes on these benders, he's in between completely lucid and completely just gibberish type of posts, and it's kind of beautiful. And I wanted to take this stuff and just I don't want to miss this exit, so that's why if I don't start talking here for a second. Where's the mall? The Old Navy. No, I think it's a little further up. So he writes in, you know, a lot of bad. When he's clear-minded, his prose is not horrible. So the sentences are there, lacking of capitalization and punctuation. But so my idea for the book would be to, and the one thing I can't figure out is how do I want to include the voices of the other people in the thread in the forum that he then interacts with. So I haven't been able to figure that out yet. Where is this fucking over here? Shopping mall. But, you know, and I have a name for it that is perfect. It goes along great, perfect with his, I guess I'll just say, no one looks at these anyway, so I'll just go ahead and say it. But his handle is Dirt Merchant. Dirt Merchant. And I thought the perfect name for the book would be my taking this stuff, putting it into a different context with like complete sentences and paragraphs and book form and chapters, and easier to read, cut and pasting and editing, line editing, to a certain degree, not line editing. Let's say like line editing. If you know what that means, it's not quite what I'd be doing, but it'd be stealing, but it'd be also kind of, and there's this sick, perverse sense that he might die. People talk about this a lot, like he could die. And so I had this idea of just starting with the fact that because we are all going to die eventually, and who knows how long this thread can go on for. It could go on for a long time. So maybe the voices would be friends talking about him, and I would change the tense of each post to them reflecting on his life versus him being alive in a present tense. I don't know. It's good to work that out, though. It's something I'd have to think about a little more. Wow, there's some fucking weird skies going on right now. I'm going to take a photo of them and on my vlog, gunvernonhell.com, so you can check out that. But I'm at Old Navy. Holy shit. Lightning just went crazy. Let's see if I can capture this.